Hey, Unicorn here, and today we are going to farm the Deadmines. The instance is located in Moonbrook in Westfall. Once you are in the city, you head into this farmer building, and a hidden cave starts on the second floor. If you don't know the way to the portal, you should definitely use the map and save the time running into dead ends. The first thing we do in the instance is sending the loot from previous runs to the vendor located in this corner. For the Alliance, it's this guy, and the Horde gets a vending machine. We then head into the first room and pull all ogres. The kobolds will follow, and kill them together with Gluptok, who we need to kill to progress. Behind him spawns the first treasure chest in the left tunnel. We then again have to stop and kill Helix Gearbreaker to open the door, and it doesn't get better in the tunnel after that. Each of the three packs has a caster that will only follow you very slowly, so you have to kill them there. On the good side though, there are these two neutral mobs that have a chance to drop the gloves and trousers of the Blackened Devious set. I even made a complete guide about just farming those two because the set is so profitable. After this tunnel, we encounter Foe Reaper 5000, which again opens the door once dead and requires you to kill the four adds in front of him to activate. While waiting on that, you can loot the two boxes of assorted parts, which contain low engineering parts, of which some sell for quite a bit of gold. The next tunnel has another chest, and the casters in these packs actually follow you. The last door doesn't need a boss to open, you just use this cannon. Make sure to avoid the other cannons though that get fired at this way to the ship. On the ship, I pull the two packs to the right and then do a complete circle the other way. All pirates on the ship have a chance to drop a pirate pet, which is worth around 200 gold. I pull them together behind this wall and kill them with Admiral Rip's Nahl. After that is done, you can head into the ship's cavern and kill Captain Cookie for the instance reward. Now all you have to do is run back, for which you can use the Goblin Teleporter and port yourself all the way back to the second boss. A perfect run like this takes about 7 minutes, but most of the time you'll need closer to 8 minutes. I did my 10 runs and calculated the gold per hour with 7.5 minutes, so here's what we got. A massive amount of enchanting mats worth 400 gold, some herbs, ore and leather from a chest worth 90 gold, nearly 500 wool and 500 linen cloth together coming in at 480 gold, the engineering mats from the boxes near the Foe Reaper boss worth 130 gold, some gems adding another 50 gold, 12 recipes worth a total of 1100 gold, and two of the pirate pets currently worth 500 gold together. This results in 2200 gold per hour without transmog, but of course we are going to see how much adding transmog could change that. Sadly, most of the greens I got weren't transmog items but gave a nice amount of enchanting mats. In total, I only got the 13 transmog items you currently see on the screen, which add up to a total of 3300 gold and bring us to 4800 gold per hour. As always, you can find the exact items I got on my blog, which is linked in the info below. Next week, we are visiting Shadowfang Keep. Thanks for watching this video. Bye.